Yeah, give me the words and I got the flow. See, I don't gotta write, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, that's called a ghost writer. Jeremiah 5 and 14, that's so fire. Isaiah 14 and when I retire, out of captivity, I broke the iron. Who that is coming out of Mount Zion? Woolly head, looking like a lion.
1,000 men marching with no drums on, no trombone, just boots on. Use our voices screaming out, take care of your homes, take care of your wives, take care of your own.
Now we standing out here in the valley of the bones. This place called America, this is not your home. This is like a tomb, place where you died at. Now I resurrected, trying to bring the 12 tribes back.
I came on a slave ship and
I ain't even like that.
Put my neck in a rope and I couldn't even fight back.
So welcome to Four Corners News.
That's right, where the truth speaks. To my left,
Officer Azanai.
And to his left,
Officer Phillip.
And to my right,
Officer Daniel.
And to his right,
Officer Pagiel.
And we make up Four Corners News.
That's right. Hey, Officer Daniel, your wife is here, man. You ain't got to stare into the camera.
I did that again?
Oh, yeah, you did.
Well, I'm kind of rough today, so
hey, that's for the replay. That's for the replay.
Yeah, the replay. She go back and watch it. I was looking at you, baby.
Come on now, dog.
I just like to see you brought that scripture out.
Welcome to Four Corners News, where the truth speaks, where we bring the Bible to life, showing you that the Bible is a true book.
That's right.
All right. Hey, let's get into it. Some of the top stories out here. We do have a sister that obviously she committed suicide. She jumped from one of the buildings in New York. Let's go to that article. Let's pull it up. She was a former Miss America from what the article says. But let's pull it up and get some more detail on it. We can't see the top of that. There we go. Let's read that.
Miss USA 2019 Chelsea Christ jumps to her death from New York City condo building.
Read the little words up underneath. It's Miss America for 2019. Read the words underneath.
Christ jumped from the 29th floor of the 60-story Orion condominium building, according to police.
Damn.
Damn.
That's terrible right there, man. That is terrible. 29th floor is, I'm going to tell you this right now, that it ain't, this is why, give me that in Isaiah 26, and I believe it's verse 3. That's why you got to detach from this world, because the things of this world, they put more pressure on you, and sometimes it gets to be so much for some people that they take their own life of jumping from a 29th floor. Wow. Damn, that's a long way down.
Yeah.
Read that, man. Isaiah 26 and verse 3. Let's read that.
Isaiah chapter 26 and verse 3.
Read it out.
That will keep him in perfect peace.
Uh-huh.
Whose mind is stayed on thee.
That's what your mind got to stay on the Most High. In this captivity right here, it got to stay on the Most High, because Esau has put many stumbling blocks in front of us, in our soul, to cause us to stumble, to get us to the point where we think that taking our life is the only solution, is the best way out of whatever problem that we are facing at that particular moment. But it's not, because if we just do what God says, read that again, verse 3.
That will keep him in perfect peace,
uh-huh,
whose mind is stayed on thee.
Your mind has to stay on the Most High in this captivity. It got to, because right, it's a lot going on in this world. Go ahead.
Because.
No, go ahead, Daniel.
Oh, I thought you was going to finish. But yeah, Cap, I was just thinking upon what you were saying. That shows how much importance it is, a necessity is, for this gospel to be preached by the prophets.
Right. Yep.
Because just like how God told Isaiah in Isaiah 61 about going to the brokenhearted, these people are out here going through these things and they don't know what to do.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the importance of it.
Exactly. And you know what's crazy too? You know, she's Miss America, right?
Yeah.
She has a lot of pressure to stay the way she is.
Yeah, like yeah. Size, keep up with the standards of beauty. Yep.
Standard of beauty, all that, right? Yeah. So a lot of these people, they go through things behind closed door. You would never know it.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. What is it? What did they say? Biggie said that back in the day, more money, more problems.
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
Right. We all, and maybe that's why the Lord ain't letting none of us hit the lottery.
Bring it up.
Go crazy. Right. We might bug out and jump off a building.
You damn right. We might have $100 million worth of problems and not know what to do, and we get to that point. We don't want to ever get to that point. Give me that in Matthew 11. Go ahead, officer, real quick. Matthew 11, 28. Go ahead.
Well, usually what rich people end up saying, they said being broke was a lot better because they ain't got to deal with the type of problems that riches they bring forth.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of stuff that comes behind that. Just like what the scripture says in Timothy, it's a lot of wickedness and evil devices that comes behind that. It opens you up to more of what's already in our spirit.
Yeah.
So God purposely does not, he gives us he what we us need back. Daily so that way we could be able
that's
to survive
what,
and
Solomon
not turn
prayed
away.
For, right?
Yeah.
Right. That's give me
Solomon.
Food convenient for me that I do not steal. And just enough that I do not, I'm butchering it, but it's basically turn on God.
Yeah, right. That's pretty what much said. What it is. And we seen Solomon's life when we had, when he had everything.
Yeah.
Like he did, his kids, he just went and partied, did whatever he wanted to do. Yeah. As, you know, Bishop Hormone. Brought out the understanding.
Poverty. Yeah, no. Give me not poverty, right? Give me, poverty, give me that Matthew 11, read 28 and 29.
Matthew chapter 11 and verse 28.
Cause this is we could bring this out in just in case, because somebody said online, Praveen said on her father was Polish. Okay, she might have been, but our people, just so we don't get to that point, because we got even more stressed than anybody on the face of the earth as a people, and we've normalized it to the point where this is our life. So we don't, you don't see suicide high amongst Israelites, but it is on the rise a little bit. We brought it out before. It is on the rise in these last days due to social media with these young kids. They're growing up in a with a mindset they have to keep up with the likes of the world. Like if they don't get 100 likes on a picture, then they are depressed. So we bring out these scriptures just in case we fall into that, even if she wasn't Israel. Read that, Matthew 11, 20, 28, 29. Appreciate that, Praveen. Go ahead.
Matthew chapter 11 and verse 28.
Yep.
Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden.
Heavy laden goes into what? Depression. Go ahead.
And I will give you rest.
You got to come to Christ. Coming to Christ means you got to learn of him, and he will give you rest. Where? In your mind. That rest translates to what? Peace. You'll have peace. You'll understand that, hey, man, don't none of this damn thing matter. And we be moving around a lot. Especially down here, we be seeing these damn million-dollar mansions and these yachts and these damn Ferraris and these Bentleys and like Skittles around here. Mm-hmm. And you be looking at it, you like, damn, that's a nice car right there. Yeah. That Maserati, nice right there. Damn, what do I have to do to get me one of them? Us having learned of Christ and having the peace of God in our spirit, we might have that thought, but the scripture pop up in our mind, all it's going to burn up. Right. Hey, don't trip, buddy. All it's going to burn up. And don't even worry about that car. It's going to burn the hell up.
And Cap, just to land back off of you, just by you seeing all of this and, you know, even some of the stuff that, you know, you talked about when you click on a video and you see an ad how to get rich quick.
Cryptocurrency.
TikTok.
Yeah.
Everybody got a damn solution on how to become rich.
Damn YouTube videos vex your spirit.
Yeah.
If you are selling anything on Amazon Prime, you're losing money. This is the new way in 2022.
Yeah. I flagged it behind.
Do not recommend channel. Click.
Because go back to the article real quick. I want to see something real quick, and then I'm gonna perform a miracle in the name of Christ.
You gonna multiply the fish?
Yeah. Scroll down to the article.
Cap gonna multiply the fish.
Yeah. Watch this. Let's read that. Chelsea Crist,
the 30-year-old winner of Miss USA 2019. Jumped to her death from the 29th floor of the Orion condominium building on Sunday morning, according to the NYPD.
And check this out. Being 30 years old, that she grew up, when was that, 1990, 92? So she grew up, but there goes my miracle of multiplying fish, y'all, if y'all didn't know.
Surprise!
Bang!
Shabang!
Here we go.
Shazam!
But being 30 years old, so if she grew up in the 90s, right? She was born in the 90s and really didn't come to a sense of the world until around the 2000s, right? So that means she grew up in an age of social media, computers, mm-hmm. and Instagram and Facebook. Being 30 years old, she's lived a life full of pressure right. to the point where she didn't have no rest of her mind. Read verse 29 in that Matthew now.
Verse 29. Take my yoke upon you
uh-huh.
and learn of me,
uh-huh.
for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls.
There you go. You got to learn about Christ. And when it means going into learning about Christ, learn his purpose of right. what he came for,
right, right.
The mercy that he gave you,
right.
and you need to learn about his second coming. His second coming is going to give you that rest of mind to where you'll see the ways of this world, and you'll be like, man, don't none of that matter. Seek ye the kingdom of heaven first.
Yeah.
Right.
Because that'll help you hold on. That's that day-to-day therapy.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Think about, like you said, you see the evils going on left and right.
Mm-hmm.
That's the downer. But when you reminisce and reflect and meditate on the coming of Christ, well, we're going to have eternal rest.
That's right.
Right? That's the motivation. That's
the that keep you going, man. Oh, that yeah. keep you oh, going. Yeah. Give me that in 1 Peter. Last one on this. Give me that 1 Peter chapter 3. And I want you to read verse 1, the top part, and then we're going to jump down to verse 3. And look what God – this is why you got to learn of Christ, right? So you can get rest to your soul, because he told Peter this through the Spirit. 1 Peter 3, let's read verse 1, and then we'll jump down. Let's read just the top part of 1.
1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 1.
Yeah.
Likewise, ye wives, be in subjection to your own husbands.
So likewise, talk about wives going into women also, right? Jump down to verse 3 now. Look what he says about women. Read that.
Verse 3. Whose adorning, let it not be of that outward adorning.
That's that sister right there. She was the what? The 2019 Miss America.
Yes, right.
So
right,
that lets you know that she was very conscious, self-conscious right. about her looks. We don't know why she took her life and jumped from a 30th floor. But it was a 30th floor. Right. But it lets you know that it had to have something to do being self-conscious with the looks, right? Mm-hmm. Read that. That probably played a part in the other stuff that came right, along right. with it that caused her to do that. Mm-hmm. Read on in that.
Adorning of plaiting of the hair and of wearing of gold or of putting on of apparel.
Don't be so caught up in your physical appearances.
Bring it up.
Know that is that's your beauty is your defense mechanism, right? Right. You get you get through this world by your beauty,
by
you know.
Your looks.
Yeah, by your looks. You get through the world a lot of times by your looks. Things are made easier in certain situations
right.
going
right.
along with your intelligence that you have, but your looks play a part too. We all know that the damn ugly sisters don't get into the club for free. Let's be honest now.
No
this
VIP.
Is where the truth speaks.
No right. VIP.
No VIP for you. You stand in the line and you pay with everybody else.
You go in the back of the line. Too,
yeah, and you got to pay for your drinks. Nobody's buying your drinks.
Oh,
we're going to speak the truth here. This is where truth speaks. Do you understand? So it looks is a part of a woman's way of maneuvering through this world.
Right.
But Christ is saying, verse 4, read that.
Verse 4. But let it be the hidden man of the heart.
That's Christ that is in you. That's Christ that is in you that should shine forth. Read on.
In that which is not corrupt.
Uh-huh.
Even the ornament of a meek and quiet spirit.
Uh-huh.
Which is in the sight of God of great price.
That's what is the most important thing. It's not your outer beauty. It's your inner beauty that is the most important thing to the Most High. Because once you got inner beauty, that means that your spirit is right. And you'll have rest for your souls. And you won't end up like the
That's right.
that jumped from the 30th floor. Like Israel, we can't be there. Thou shalt not kill. That means including yourself. Right? So let's go to the next article because we got a lot of stuff going on in the news. Let's bring it up. Let's bring it up here. We're going to keep it moving. Read that for all the people that voted for Biden because he said, you ain't black unless you vote for me.
Right.
Man, that's, somebody should have slapped his ass with some baby powder when he said that. What did he say that on Breakfast Club?
Nobody checked him?
Charlemagne the God, the conscious black dude. You didn't say nothing when he said that.
Shame on your ass. He's a Christian. I just want to let that be known.
Who's a Christian?
He's a
Christian.
He listens to TD Jakes. He's trying to push TD Jakes in the forefront.
You ain't black unless you vote for me. Shut your white mouth. Look what his people doing. He did this, but look what his whole race is doing against you for you people that vote out there. Read that.
Biden sued by 8 states over a program that allows Central American children to legally reunite with parents in the United States.
Oh, so this is for all y'all that still think them white people love you. This is for y'all that still think that you are one with the rest of the people, that you are American.
Wake up call.
Wake up call right here. That they are suing Biden for introducing a bill that puts our brothers of the Northern Kingdom, the so-called Hispanics, mm-hmm. back together. You know what that goes back to? Deuteronomy 28. Yep. Give me that. Go ahead, officer.
Am I reading that correctly? Did it say he's being sued for reuniting parents with their children?
Reuniting families. Yep. The states are suing him.
We're going to read the name of the states coming up?
Yeah, we're going to read it. Go ahead, Officer Patrick. What was I going to say?
Yeah, I was going to say it's like God is saying, nah, those curses are going to... gonna manifest.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
I'm gonna show you they real.
Show you who they are. They're gonna smile in your face, but when it push come to shove, they're gonna show who they are like iron rusted. That's is what God right. says. Deuteronomy 28. What is that? 32. That we want to read. Let's read that real quick.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 32.
Read it out.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Given unto another people means that your families would be separated. They did that because they don't give a damn about the black, the Hispanic, or the Native Indian family being a what you call it? Was it, what's that word? It's
not
a
nuclear family.
A nuclear family. There you go. That's why we got you on the show. Intern. That's why we got you here.
He got the title intern. I thought he was just like a visitor.
Visitor. That's a visiting guy. You know how you know he's a visitor? He don't even know to button the top button of his damn shirt.
See, there you go. Visitor.
How you get blasted?
He did something good and it turned on him, didn't he? Yeah. Uziel, don't touch the ark. Hey, but they don't care about the nuclear family when it comes to us being apart, because they know that strong families create a strong nation. Right. They want us to be destroyed. Go back to the article and let's read those. Those states, right?
Yes.
It's the second paragraph. Read the second paragraph on that.
The attorney generals in Arkansas, Alaska, Florida, Indiana.
Hold on. Read that again.
The attorneys general in Arkansas.
Arkansas.
There you go.
Alaska.
How did Alaska get in there? Damn, they not even
That's
in.
A typo.
Northern Kingdom's not even in Alaska.
Right.
They don't want them in the vicinity.
Well, Gad, that's what. Yeah, well, but Gad ain't the ones that came across the Central American border, though.
They probably know that we all the same.
Yeah, that's what it is.
They cold as hell in Alaska, and they like, damn, you let these Mexicans in.
They're going to take up all our heat. Yeah. Arkansas, Alaska, read on.
Go back.
Come on, y'all. Go ahead.
Florida.
Florida.
Indiana.
Uh-huh.
Missouri.
Indiana. Good old white state. What? Missouri, good old white state. Go ahead.
Montana.
Good old white state.
Oklahoma.
Good old white state.
And Texas.
Damn, you know they hate you down there in Texas.
Woo!
They know they hate you, Northern Kingdom. Yeah. So you know what, let you know, you damn Issachar that they call Mexicans. Stop marrying them damn white women down there. They don't want you to be with your family, your people.
And you know what's so messed up? I seen Texas on there, but Texas got the number one places with tacos and all.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Oh yeah.
White people show up and eat your damn tacos, but want you to stay separate from your family.
They call it Tex-Mex.
Remember, Texas is just an extension of Mexico.
Right. That's all it is.
I wonder if they're gonna celebrate Cinco de Mayo.
Right.
Make your tacos and go back across the border.
Right. Hey, go back to the ark and read the let's read on. We're gonna jump down to the third paragraph. Just read the next paragraph and look what Esau says of why they are suing Biden for trying to put families back together. Go ahead, read that.
There are no lawful paths for aliens.
For who?
For aliens. Man.
You just said it, Cap. That damn Texas was a part of Mexico. And they called them aliens.
Unbelievable.
Read on.
Who lack status to come join other aliens who lack status in the United States.
Keep reading, but give me that scripture in what is that, Lamentations, right? Lamentations. They cut that now we call this how you know the Bible's a true book, man. Is that now the term that God gave them has now been placed on us. Read it when you get it. I think it's 5:1 or something like that. 4:1. Go ahead.
Lamentations chapter 5:1.
Read it.
Remember, O Lord, what has come upon us.
Uh-huh.
Consider and behold our reproach.
Our reproach. They put us in cages, right? They won't let us join back with our families. Right. Go ahead.
Our inheritance is turned to strangers.
To strangers, read.
Our houses.
Our houses, America, Texas,
to aliens.
Two aliens. The white man's the alien.
Yeah.
That's, woo.
Look at that. Right, that's what they are. Wherever he go, he is considered the alien.
Yeah, he ain't got no place on.
No place.
No, he got one place.
Where?
The mountain.
Oh, the
caucus. Caucus.
Cave. Shut your white mouth.
That's where they belong. And even if those ain't theirs, because it was it was Ham in there before it was them. They just renting caves.
Damn.
You know what's the crazy part about it is? What we're seeing is modern day slavery just being changed from a different name. Because what they're doing is...
Good point.
Is pretty much, you know, what the they took opportunity of what was happening in, I believe, Guatemala or El Salvador, where they had a lot of gangs, and they created a program for them to come into the United States.
Now, what you call asylum?
Asylum. Yeah, asylum. So asylum within seekers. The asylum programs, guess what they do? They end up getting money. So, so this is what we're seeing. This is another form of slavery just being enacted right in front of us.
Yeah. Freedom.
Good point. Go back to that article real quick, and the attorney generals of these states, look at the claim that they have. Go back to it. It says no sovereign nation. Let's read that.
No sovereign nation would reward those who break the law by permitting family members abroad to join them in living in the sovereign territory unlawfully.
Now, this goes back to what you just said, Officer Asinaya. Well, I thought they had a law that said about asylum seekers.
Right.
How are they breaking the law? Yeah. They let you know that the laws that they create, they not made for you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians.
Freedom.
They'll give asylum to anybody else that's overseas. They'll give it to damn Ishmael. Right. They'll give it to somebody from damn Denmark, from Ireland. But right there in damn South America and Central America, you don't have asylum. You come in here because you're just trying to smuggle in dope.
Yeah. Perfect example. Look what happened. You got Haiti.
Good point.
Just a couple of hops away from Florida.
Yep.
Right? And then you had, what's that incident that happened when Taliban took over Iraq?
Yeah, it just happened, right?
Afghanistan.
When they took all the military stuff.
Yeah, pull out the troops. Yeah.
So now they gave them what? Cargo first class ticket to America.
Cargo army planes.
They paid them to
gave
stay
them money.
Right?
And teaching them the language.
And teaching them the language.
Yep.
And then afterwards, what? They told the Haitians that tried to cross.
Yeah, y'all got to go back.
Y'all
got
to go back.
Go back. Hell
matter of fact, y'all rallying up all the ears and eyes from across the world. You know what? We're going to put you in these warehouses, and we're going to separate you from your families. And those that's real elderly that can't fight, we're going to ship y'all out.
Damn.
And the worst part about it is the Haitians, which are the Levites, they had to walk
thousands of miles.
So
and
where
they got here and said, hey, take your going back
they
home.
They showed us their foot. Yeah. Their foot was cut up.
Yeah. Whoa.
They had to see their friends die right next to them.
Rivers.
Kids die right next to them. They had to fight off a lot of different elements. They
getting
had to
sex traffic. They had to fight that off.
Sex traffic, coyotes, and people like
all
that.
All of that.
Drug traffickers risking their lives to get to America, to the Golden City.
And that happens over and over and over again, because a couple months before that, they was doing it to Benji.
Oh, yeah,
When the storm hit those
islands. Oh, yeah, in the Caribbean. They wouldn't let them come here.
They wouldn't let them come over.
Wow. And you know what's
they
so crazy?
Puerto Rico.
What's so crazy about that, that proves that what Trump said behind closed doors that was never proven is true.
They don't want refugees or people seeking asylum from them asshole.
Yeah, yeah, there you go.
That proves that that's exactly
Israelites. Israelites, basically.
Israelites can't see. Ain't no asylum over here for Israelites.
Yeah, ain't no asylum for us over here. That's crazy. Hey, you can keep on doing that, but hey, this is what is getting prepared for you. Show what Kim Jong-un, I think that's his name, Kim Jong-un, is over there doing. Rocket Man is what they call him. Look what he's over there doing. Pull that up real quick. Read that for us.
Kim Jong-un wants the world to know.
You got good, would that be Mandarin is what they call
Mandarin,
it?
Mandarin.
Yeah, I don't know. I'll be watching Mandarin. Netflix and it says Mandarin. Mm-hmm. Well, yeah. Korean? I think the language is Mandarin. I don't know.
Who gives a damn?
Lord, call them
all. All we need to do, once we don't need to know their language, just Lord, put them in chains. Go ahead, read that name again.
Kim Jong-un
wants
the world to know he still matters.
Uh-huh.
7 missile tests in a month.
Yeah, keep going. Yeah, yeah, that's what he's over there doing.
Hey, that dude is Rocket crazy.
Man. Yeah, Rocket Man. Give me that Joel chapter 9, Joel chapter 3, verse 9. Yeah, you want to, you Edomites, you want to keep showing your hatred toward the people of God, bitch, be the blacks, the Hispanics, and you keep wanting to do that? God is preparing these other nations to wipe your ass there off the face of the earth.
Right. That's right.
With Rocket Man getting ready.
Hey, Cap, I knew Rocket Man was crazy because he wore a leather shirt and he made a leather jacket. He made a law saying anybody that wear a leather jacket
get put to the Oh, he did,
Wow.
He wore a long leather jacket and made a law. If anybody wear a leather jacket like me, you're going to die by firing squad.
Wow. Damn.
Man, he wants to be exclusive, don't he? Give me that. Read that verse 9 and 10 real quick.
Joel chapter 3 and verse 9.
Uh-huh.
Proclaim ye this among the Gentiles.
Uh-huh.
Prepare war.
Prepare what?
Prepare war.
Yeah, that's what God's preparing. Read on.
Wake up, the mighty men.
Uh-huh.
Let all the men of war draw near.
Uh-huh.
Let them come up.
Let them come up, meaning meet God in the valley of Jehoshaphat. That's where he wants you to meet him. Right. Go ahead, read verse 10.
Beat your plowshares into swords.
Yeah, all those that you farmers and things, I want you to come too. Go ahead.
And your pruning hooks into spears.
Uh-huh. This is the point right here.
Let the weak say.
Let the weak say. The weak would be North Korea.
Right.
A little bitty country. Let the weak say that what?
I am strong.
I got missiles just got like missiles. You do, America.
Right.
I got nuclear bombs just like you do.
Look at me.
Hey, boy,
you have to be scared of the Most High.
Yeah.
You ever seen movies where you know the person who's the
underdog,
who's strong,
yeah,
and they give you the weapon? Yeah, you can have that weapon. You know you about to get your butt tore.
Yeah.
The Lord is basically telling you, go ahead, get all the weapons you want.
Yeah,
get the missiles and come on down.
Yeah, because America was the first country that had that nuclear bomb,
right,
and all of that stuff. And now the other nations are getting those things, and they say, hey, big bad wolf, yeah, we know
we
how you used to rule the whole world in great fearfulness, but now you done gave us that technology, we're going to use it to come back and fight your ass. We're going to hit you right on the chin, you big bully.
I'm telling America how to flinch. I dare you to flinch.
I dare you. That's what we see right here with King Jong-un. How you say it again?
Kim Jong-un.
He in the spirit, God is making him in the spirit say, let the weak say that I am strong. They're getting ready for World War III.
That's
right. Also in the news, black Americans, you got a whole bunch of money. You work a lot. You know, you got all kind of money, but you ain't got nothing to show for it. And the Atlanta Black Star, they posted an article on that. Let's pull it up and see what they said. Let's read that real quick.
Black Americans have over $1 trillion. Spending power. Can that be redirected to help close the wealth gap? Experts weigh in.
No, it won't. I'm going to tell you why it won't close up the wealth gap, because God said you're always going to be oppressed and crushed evermore. And give me that in Romans chapter 12, verse 2. This goes, you can give black people all the money in the world you want to, but it ain't going to work until this one thing happens. Read that.
Romans chapter 12 and verse 2.
Uh-huh.
And be not conformed to this world.
That's the problem. We are conformed to this world. We like keep it up with the Joneses. We want the fancy things. Read on.
But be ye transformed
uh-huh.
by the renewing of your mind.
The renewing of your mind goes into having a spirit of unity.
That's right.
We don't have that as a people. It's get rich or die trying. It's YOLO. What's it called?
You only live once.
You only live once.
Right.
We live by those things. We got what's that little dumb little boy that you know, he be shaking his shoulder like a sodomite.
Uzi Vert.
Oh, is it Uzi Vert? Uzi.
What are you talking about, little Nas?
Little Uzi Vert. That's his name.
You gotta put the little okay. in front of it. Okay. he said Uzi Vert.
Yeah, you okay. talking about the one that put that little diamond on his.
Yeah, body. How much yeah. did that cost, officer? Oh, how do you know?
I don't even remember. I don't know.
$25 million. He put a damn diamond in the middle of his forehead.
He just lived that vert. I mean, that title that he just brought up.
Yeah,
he
had exactly. the money. Right. It don't matter how much money we got. It ain't going to work. Go to the article and look what the expert said about it, because they really quoted the Bible about the mind being transformed and didn't even know it. Read that in that article. Let's read that real quick. Read through it.
Black Americans are estimated to have more than $1 trillion in buying power in coming years.
Uh-huh.
Marking the highest amount of spendable cash they have ever wielded in U.S. history.
Read on.
Still, that money won't necessarily translate into an opportunity to build
wealth. Go ahead.
Experts told Finura, adding that building wealth isn't solely about having dollars to spend year after year.
Now check this. Look what he says. Read on.
It's going to take sweeping federal policy.
Oh, stop right there. There you go. Yeah. There you go. There you go. We depended on the other nations. Once again, you're depending on your oppressor. Without them, we do not see a way of getting up out of captivity. It has to be help from the white man. Without sweeping federal policy, we have no way of getting money.
What sweeping policy you need to build a school?
Right.
What sweeping there you policy go. You need to build a supermarket with real good food to
come out what policy do you need when you've got $1 trillion worth of spending power to build a hospital?
Come on.
For your people. To build a damn grocery store that serves genuine
food.
Food stuff that ain't damn Fago. Fago pop it damn.
Come on.
Jake's still slaves, so they got to ask permission. Yeah.
There you go.
And you know what else that shows? You know how a lot of people be saying the problem with black people is that we don't have businesses. We don't have economic system, all that, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So all that right there just shuts it down because we've been had money.
Right. There you go.
The money there. Yeah.
We got the money. Go back to the article. Go back to the article and let's continue reading that.
It's going to take sweeping federal policy combined with black Americans investing in themselves in order to truly close the black-white wealth gap, according to experts.
Continue reading. Go on to the next one. Let's read the next one. Go ahead.
The problem is so large.
Woo, the problem is what?
Is so large.
Uh-huh.
And has lingered for so long that it will take sustained large and targeted policy intervention from a federal government perspective.
Give me that. Give me that. Man. What is that I want? Lamentations 4:17.
Bring it out.
We are still in the mindset. That's why no matter how much money we get, it is not going to change anything because our mind has not been renewed.
Bring it out.
Read that. Lamentations chapter 4, verse 17 to show. Because we keep saying federal government, that ain't nothing but trusting in your oppressor.
There you go.
Read that.
That's it.
Lamentations chapter 4 and verse 17.
Bring it out.
As for us, our eyes as yet failed for our vain help.
Uh-huh.
In our watching, we have watched for a nation that could not save us.
That's what your sweeping federal policy is going into. God saying ain't no federal policy going to change the oppression and the poverty that we are in as a nation, because the curse that God placed on us for rebelliousness is that thou shalt be oppressed and spoiled forevermore.
There you
hey,
go.
And you know what's so crazy about that, Cap? When I hear that term, closing the wealth gap, our people's mind is so sick. What we're really trying to do is get the same amount of money as
there you go.
So
yeah.
we can live among each other.
There you go.
So
that's
Israel
it.
Can finally
Damn.
Accept us.
That's it.
That's what they want.
Good point.
They want equality.
Bring it up, man.
Hey, get Haggai
good
1.
Script, man.
Haggai good, 1. I'm going to land back on what y'all said just right there.
Good point.
Haggai chapter 1, start at verse 4.
Bring it out.
Come on.
We don't want to exceed Esau. No. We just want to be like equal.
Because perfect example, look at what happened to Jay-Z. Didn't the NFL give him almost $1 billion?
Yeah.
And he said he was going to go in there and change things
Reform!
Up, right?
Get a black owner! We're going to go into that a little later. Go ahead.
Bring that out. Read.
Haggai chapter 1 and verse 4.
Uh-huh.
Is it time for you, O ye, to dwell in your sealed houses?
Sealed houses, your mansions, right? Come on.
and this house lie waste.
While really your nation lies decimated.
Yeah.
They don't have a school. Actually, now they have to depend on a federal policy.
There you
go.
Damn. What you call it? That's the HBCUs, right? That's donations from white folk.
Right.
When we got $1 trillion worth of spending power, we still asking white people, please support our black colleges.
Cap, you know what that's called? That's a pimp to harlot relationship.
Damn.
We have become the harlots, and then
pimps
they
up,
are
holds
the
down. Y'all never seen that, have you? Y'all ain't never seen it. It was an old HBO. I'm showing my age here. Let me get my story time real quick. Don't forget your thought. It was an old HBO series thing, man. It was called Pimps Up, Hoes Down. Man. You ever seen that, Officer Phillip? Yeah. I know Levi ain't never seen
that.
But it was. That's where the dude named Don Juan Bishop, the dude that rolled
with
Snoop.
With the green
that's
suit,
where he got famous from, that thing right there, pimping out hoes. And that's the same thing as you saying America does to us. Go ahead, Officer. Break it out.
And a lot of the times what we do, since we have such low self-esteem, because the thing that's going to give us esteem is just the Bible. When we look at where we come from and exactly who our forefathers is, because that our nationality has been stripped away from us, we have been reduced down to becoming harlots.
That's it.
So because we have been reduced to becoming harlots, now we got to make daddy happy with
you.
Oh, man.
Damn, that's an old pimp talk phrase right there, man. Right. Might want to check see what he was doing in
what
the world.
What we do, we chasing a bag now. That's the term,
There you go.
Chasing a bag.
Yep. And who got the bag? Daddy, dude.
And once you get the bag, what you going to do with the bag?
You going to give it to Papa.
You're
going to give it to
my
sugar daddy.
You want another stimmy? No problem.
You going to give it back.
You're going to give it right now.
You ain't got nowhere else to spend it. Hey, go back to the article. I want you to check this out, because we're going to give you money, and this is the thought that black people are going to have, but look what the experts say. Go to the article. Read that. Go to the next one. Go to the next part of it. Read that right there.
Weller and other experts said many Americans incorrectly...
Black people. Go ahead.
...incorrectly believe spending more money at black-owned businesses will solve the wealth gap problem.
But it won't. No. Keep reading. He's going to say it.
It's going to take more than just redirecting $1.7 trillion to help generate more black wealth, the experts said. Starting and supporting more black businesses alone won't do the trick.
Hold on. You mean, so this push that black people, hey, with black people, you need to own business. You need to get your businesses. You need to do this. You need to do that. It's with these shop black old, it ain't going to change the wealth gap problem we got, because God said you only going to be oppressed. Right. You're going to live your life in poverty here as a nation. Right. Yeah, you might have your little house here. You have a little house there. But I want y'all to know this. I'm going to tell you this, too. For all you black people that don't know, they got money. LeBron James might got money. He ain't got as enough money as the damn Lakers owner. The Lakers owner can afford to pay him $200 million worth of money. Steph Curry, $200 million, and then pay the rest of the team a total of $200 million. Right. What is that saying about the damn owner then? That means that the money that you get, and even if it's $200 million, $300 million, nigga, that ain't number crumbs to me. Keep making me laugh.
And on top of that, Cap, even though if they do got the money, soon as they the way Esau set it up is, once they get that money, distract them with so much things, wealth and this, spend your money here. Well, you won't even have the good idea to bring that money back to your people.
Yeah, right, yeah.
No, that thought won't even cross your mind.
Nah, you're going to go buy you some, what's some high-priced clothes, because I shop
Versace,
at Ross.
Versace, Gucci.
Come on. Okay.
Versace, Gucci.
You need to keep
Louis
up with
Vuitton,
the cars.
Versace, Yeezy.
Gucci, Dior.
Man, y'all brothers be looking at that stuff, huh? Y'all know all the damn names.
Yeah, you seen that
before. I see. You saw that? They named it off top, didn't they?
I still rock food.
I was going to say some damn polo sport. I got some Game On shorts. I got.
I rock on.
And one. That's me, FUBU. Nah, FUBU's old, though. We used to have FUBU.
Hey, I rock FUBU. Come on.
You still rock FUBU?
Yeah, man, you still got
rock on.
Put the camera on this guy.
The FUBU with the...
I rock the FUBU shoes.
Fat Albert. The one with the Fat Albert.
Fat Albert for us by
Fila's.
Us.
Hey, Cap. Yeah.
Fila's.
Cap, remember Fila's. Pepe jeans?
Pepe jeans, right?
Hush Puppies. Buffalinos.
Buffalinos, damn.
That's high for us poor people.
But put the camera down there on them, over there. Put the camera on them Generation over there. Z. Yeah, but they.
Oh, was, no.
Yeah, what was name, those name those off again one more time for us.
Sean John.
Oh, no, you plead the fifth now.
Oh, now you're quiet.
Jesus is the answer.
Yeah, but that's what we do. We, like you said, we take that money and then we give it right to those people there. We don't even wear FUBU no more. That's literally, the name literally stands for us, by us, and black people don't even wear it no more. It's, oh, no, give me that Louis, that Gucci, that Fendi, that Michael Kors.
I remember when that whole flood happened, the hurricane hit New Orleans, right? I remember it was Kanye and Oprah. They went down there and rebuilt the whole block. Yes, they redid a whole block, and nobody else did anything. You didn't hear nobody else going down there, especially knowing the disaster that hit.
Uh-huh.
Nobody else did nothing. They had enough money to redo a whole block.
Whoa,
just
block. I let you know they got money.
Come on.
Yep,
you heard, was it Master P? He was redoing the projects.
Yeah.
You know what it is?
Nothing else from nobody else.
Hold on. Let's finish this out. Finish this article out. Let's go back to it. We about to go commercial here in a minute. Let's read that starting and supporting.
Starting and supporting more black businesses alone won't do the trick, because if you're a black business
owner. Now check this out, Cap. If you're a black business owner,
you're starting from further behind than a white-owned company.
You ain't got it. That's what we just said. You Negroes that got fancy cars and stuff, that ain't nothing compared to the money them white people got. Right. And the reason why you don't know that they got this money, because a damn white person will be a millionaire and shop at damn TJ Maxx.
Oh, right.
They have on some damn Saucony's shoes. And they will wear them till they run out. I'll run down to the ground and buy another pair of Saucony shoes, and the damn Negro out here is trying to look like they got money like them, and you don't. You just starting so far behind, it's no catch it up, is what basically what they're saying.
Yeah.
It's no catch it up even if you start your businesses. None at all.
Mm. It's never going to work.
Never going to work. Thus saith the Lord.
Hello, Israel. This is Bishop Nathaniel. I want you to know that you can view all our Sabbath classes live on IUIC TV. That's right. I said on IUIC TV. Download the app today. Shalom.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.